Hi guys, this is James from Devil's Paintbrush, and we're having another look at the Mantic things I bought from Salute. This is the GCPS exclusive box set. Focus. Yeah, the Salute exclusive box set, and it's all built, as you can see. And GCPS is the Mantic version of Imperial Guard, and I'm going to be using these as Imperial Guard for 8th edition 40k that's coming out next month. This is not a very competitive list in 40k, and quite frankly I'm not really bothered because I don't really do competitive play anymore, just for games with friends. So I'll just run through with you what these are, and we'll look at some of my favourite poses, and then I'll explain what my plans are for expanding this into the world of 40k. So anyway, we have the five-man command team led by a company commander. We have the masterwork character from Mantic, who's going to be a colonel. We have the limited edition character from Mantic, who I don't know what she's going to be. Maybe an attachment to the command squad, or maybe if I split these guys up, which are going to be stormtroopers, she can be the sergeant for them. We have two infantry squads with heavy weapons, a Voxcaster and a grenade launcher. At the back there we have another 10-man squad, this time with just a grenade launcher and a Voxcaster. And we have these two striders, which I'm going to use as sentinels. So we're just going to have a look at a couple of the models. Here's the focus. Here's the company commander. A little bit of conversion work to give him a power sword. What would be a las pistol, although it looks like a bolt pistol. And this young lady here is going to be the medic. She's got some of the accessory packs that came with the box set. And this guy's got a master vox, so it's one of the other vox units you get with the sprues. There's the colonel. He is equipped with a plasma pistol and a power fist, or the equivalent of. And here's the special ops special character, equipped with a bolt pistol. And when I get some more stuff, I'm going to give her a power sword. And then we've got these stormtrooper dudes here. They use exactly the same legs and torso, but you get this backpack here, an enclosed helmet, and they look very Halo, I have to say. We've got this guy here with a grenade launcher. And we've got this running pose with I'm going to use these as hell guns, but they're a different type of rifle to the standard troopers that you'll see in a second. This guy is another favourite of mine. And then we've got, here's the Vox dude from the other lot, and as you can see, the rifles are slightly different, they're more streamlined, so they're going to be las guns. He's got a standard Vox unit. We have the sergeant. I give most of the sergeants stormtrooper helmets just to make them stand out. And then that's one of the standard troopers. In fact, these ones look very mobile infantry from Starship Troopers. We've got another sergeant here, so I'm checking his watch. And then we're going to have a look at some of the heavy weapons. This guy's looking at a scanner. I haven't glued any of them down for ease of painting. We have the ammo box. And then we have what I'm going to use as an autocannon, which is much more useful than a heavy bolter for taking out light vehicles. And there's the gunner. And then over here we have the missile launcher team. This guy looking through a pair of binoculars. The missile launcher itself. And then the operator. And again, I've given him a stormtrooper helmet. that squad, there's nothing different to the others, all focused massively. There we go. And now we've got the Striders. This came with the option of having what looked like a plasma cannon and a chainsaw, which looked more like Space Marine Dreadnought type thing. It's come on focus. But these are really nice models. And these guys are going to represent armoured Sentinels with plasma cannon. And this one being a bit more active. So there you go. That is the GCPS box from Mantic, the exclusive Salute one. Now, later on in the year, I think it's September, the vehicles for these guys are going to be released, because these are one of the armies that are due to release further on in the year compared to the stuff that's being released later this month, which is going to be Forge Fathers and, oh, they're equivalent to Space Marines, I can't remember what they're called. Anyway, so the vehicle for these guys, called the Mule, is very similar to the Imperial Guard Turoks. So I'm going to get some of those. They're going to be my transport vehicles. The Flyer that's coming with them is very similar to actually a Storm Talon, but we use those as Valkyries or Vendettas. But when it comes to brute force and tankage, Lehman Russ. So my next purchase is for these guys. Again, much later on, after 8th is properly done, will be a couple of Lehman Russ. So I can take on the enemies of the Imperium. So there you go, guys. Hope you found it useful. They're great fun to build, and they're true scale, not historic scale like 40k. So that was an interesting. It was more interesting to build them because you had to consider proper human poses rather than heroic poses. Anyway, I've waffled on a lot and enough. So as usual, guys, thanks for watching. Like and subscribe and all that jazz. And I'll catch you next time.